The next topic is ecosystem-based management, EBM, ecosystem-based management. Now, in defining this, ek to aise terms ka na definition yaad rakhna. If not exact words, know the approximate terms that you should use. What is ecosystem-based management? Head down. It is a management practice that ensures conservation of natural ecosystems and their restoration, while also ensuring meeting the needs of social, economic, political, and cultural needs of the present and the future generations. So, four concepts here. It's about maintaining ecosystems and the ecosystem services. So, pehla word hai aapka, maintain karo usko. Second hai, jahan kharab ho gaya usko, restore karo. Third is, you must meet the needs. There are four type of needs. And the fifth phrase is, of future and the present. Iske bahut sare forms hain. Okay, you can also use one more. According to Stuart Shepin, EBM or ecosystem-based management is application of ecological science to resource management to promote long-term sustainability of ecosystems. To promote long-term sustainability of ecosystems and delivery of essential ecosystem goods and services. Any environment issue, any environment or ecology-based answer, is theme end kar sakte ho. Okay, disaster management, agriculture issues, water management mein, watershed development is a type of ecosystem-based management which ensures, likho ye paragraph wapas. So some of these terms you have to memorize, theek hai? That's one of them, so I'm giving you verbatim here. In ecosystem-based management, what is it we are trying to ensure? If I talk in terms of what are the attributes I'm ensuring, I want to ensure that our solutions are relevant. This area ko jo chahiye aap wahi kar rahe ho. The solutions are efficient. The solutions are adaptive. And they are adoptable. And they are sustainable. So, ये सब keywords हैं. Okay, you all know what the idea means. जब लिखने बोलेंगे, you'll have problems of the word precision. I'm trying to hammer that down into your heads. Okay, ये five is what I want to ensure. So, you know, definition of ecosystem management and what am I trying to do? The solutions have to be relevant. When I say relevant, I'm talking about local area based solutions. About the local climate, local land, local water, usse relevant hona chahiye. You can't apply the principles of the hill areas to principles of the marshes. Relevant ho. Efficient ho. Efficient in terms of not just money, in terms of efforts, in terms of okay, the inputs, in terms of the economy they generate, they must be efficient. They must be adaptive. Iska matlab kya hai? How is adaptive word different from adoptable? Yes, adaptive ka matlab ye hai. It must be flexible. Because conditions change. A flood problem solve kar rahe ho. In today's context, it can't be same as what we are doing maybe 20 years ago. Tab kuch aur pata tha hame. Technology changes, priority changes. So development of UP mein, okay, aapne jab pehle kiya tha, kuch aur model hua hoga. Today is different. Okay, climate change ho raha hai. It must be adaptive. Okay, so adaptive in terms of what? In terms of technology. In terms of priority. Adaptive in terms of changing conditions. Ye conditions mein social conditions change ho gaya, economic conditions change ho gaya. Somewhere, adaptable is part of relevance also. If you have a program, local people refuse to participate. Okay, your program is down the drain. Okay, think of this in the context of stubble burning in Punjab. In terms of even behavior change, a lot of environmental problems can solve if you can change my behavior. So, you have to do something where the new systems are adoptable. It can be about price. It can be about accessibility. It can be about attitudes here. and sustainable, long-term, okay, relevance hona chahiye. Should be long-term relevance, intergenerational somewhere. Sustainability is also part of, adaptive is also part of relevance. These are the five things I want to ensure if I am trying to implement ecosystem-based management. Clear? A third aspect. Ek to main definition bata diya aapko, kya definition? By heart it. Second, I explained what is it I want to ensure. Okay, what is the characteristics of ecosystem-based approach? Ye characteristics hain. Now, what are the principles? Anybody knows the principles of ecosystem-based approach? These things on your fingertips, at least 4 or 5 of them. What are the principles of ecosystem-based management? Yeah. CBDR, yes. Okay, what else? Okay, polluter pays. Oops. Okay, fine. What is CBDR? Common but differentiated responsibility. ठीक है, I think Kigali. Yes. Okay. We have polluter pays principle. और क्या? Precautionary principle. Take precautions even if there is a precautionary principle. I hope you know these terms. Yeah? ये गलत है. Because आप differentiate नहीं कर रहे हो, what are the principles of environmental management and what is the principle of ecosystem based management. ये दो अलग terms हैं. Okay, so these you apply for environmental management principles. And if environment management includes ecosystem approach, okay, फिर उसका लिस्ट अलग होगा. Okay, now बहुत principles हैं. IUCN has given us 12 principles, which I'll club into 4 or 5 heads for our convenience. AP document net से I will share with you all of you. One I'll share is that case study of Okosombo project. The second I'll share is, okay, the list of principles, IUCN. But utna list yaad na rakhna, know the broad heads kya kya hai. Okay. Now, broad heads, one is around local relevance, where we say that the objectives have to be driven by local priorities. It must be based on local economic and social reality. We must ensure public participation through decentralization. So more or less, okay, I have put them all under one head called as local relevance. The second set of principles is about sustainability. Okay. In terms of time relevance, they have to be long term. Because the long term hai, so they have to be strategic. Meaning pata hai aapko tactical and strategic? A tactical word means short term. Tactical warfare. I take out a gun, you take out a gun. Okay. Tactical warfare. Strategic. Ye long term hai. You plan today, result dikhai dega aapko 10 saal ke baad mein. We are looking at long term. Okay. And for long term, they have to have adaptive strategies. So time sustainability. The management should have element of continuity. Isiliye hum kehte hain ki in this approach, there's nothing like beginning and end. Ek launch kar diya program, launch ho gaya, achievement, okay, and then you end. No. Because the fact is, objectives keep on changing. Aapka UPSC syllabus, Just when you thought ki khatam ho raha hai shayad, okay, you are given a new subject to read. Okay, just when you thought ho chuka, okay, so it's continuity. Okay, it's a continuous process with no beginning, no end. Okay, that's about sustainability. The third aspect is about principle around economics of management. Isme do point likho aap, write down here. The initiatives have to have incentives for the local population to adopt, and the cost benefits should be internalized. Basically, what I'm saying is that if the system is so designed where continuously I must support from outside transfer resources, the system won't sustain itself. The local area must generate their own revenues. The local area must have enough of options for livelihood. Incentives and punishment should be within the system itself. And we must have some kind of economic instruments also. If you leave the economics, a classic example hota hai, forest management, water management. Okay. Even in agriculture management, soil management, if you don't include the issues related to livelihood of the people, if you cannot generate enough of employment, then those practices can't be sustained. In fact, you end up alienating population if you compromise their employment. The tribes become smugglers eventually of the same timber you're trying to protect. If the economics are missing, the water usage may be unsustainable. If economics are missing, soil conservation is not a priority. Ye to ho raha hai aapka Punjab mein, kya ho raha hai? The economics of stubble burning, okay, is forcing people to burn the stubble. The government has to create something where, okay, the government can procure stubble maybe for something else. We have tried that, kuch suggestions rahe hain to convert them into biofuel and the rest. Okay, or maybe into timber industry where you can have, okay, you know, some kind of plywood construction from the stubble. Okay? So economics are very important here. You can't ignore that. And the fourth aspect is that in ecosystems approach, we must ensure, number one, the ecosystem structure is not disrupted beyond unsustainable levels. Biodiversity is conserved and managed. And third one is, the impact on adjacent ecosystems is also considered. Aisa na ho ki you are developing one area and you've forgotten what you are doing here impacts some other ecosystems also. This is what our watershed management is trying to do. Okay, so why is watershed an approach in ecosystems-based management? Okay, so ye aapko dikhana padega, okay, how they are aligned to one another. In watershed, all of this is what we're trying to do. Local, okay, relevance, efficiency in terms of cost efficiency, water use efficiency, okay, local investments mein hona chahiye, adaptive hai. It takes care of the changing ecosystems, adoptable hai, local participation hai usme. Okay, and all of this is taken care of. Remember, watershed mein kya hota hai? You are converging equity, economy, employment, okay, environment. So use all of this into discussions of any answer on ecosystem-based approach. So what is ecosystem-based management, the definition? What is it trying to ensure? Okay. What are its characteristics? And what are the principles in which it operates? And be very careful to separate these two ideas. Environmental principles is not same as ecosystems, okay, principles. Fine?